Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we ask Allah to exalt, dimension and grant peace and send his salutations upon the Prophet Muhammad. We will be beginning, inshallah, a series of episodes on One Way to Paradise, dealing with different issues and some practical advice from an Islamic point of view on how to deal with them. The first of which will be a reality that anybody who has children or will have children, inshallah, in the future, has to deal with. And that's the fact that one of the most challenging things ever is raising children Islamically. Those who are parents can attest to the validity of my statement and that it is not an exaggeration in any way, shape or form. And those who don't have children, obviously I don't want to discourage you from having any, but you have to realize that it requires a lot of patience, preparation and knowledge in order to be able to maneuver through these difficulties and reach your destination safely and successfully. And so we'll be going over, inshallah, in different episodes, 130 methods on how to raise kids in Islam. I hope, inshallah, it will be of benefit for myself and for you and will be among those who implement it. The first and most important thing when it comes to raising children Islamically is focusing on the matters of aqidah. So the first chapter will be aqidah. Aqidah obviously is the creed or what you hold on to and believe in tightly. That's why it comes from uqda, which is a knot that you tie. And so anything that you've tied your belief around is what you hold strongly to. This is known as aqidah. The first and foremost is that you should teach your children from a very young age the expression or the testimony of tawheed, la ilaha illallah. Now, of course, there are different levels of understanding. What you want to do is familiarize the children with that expression, with its meaning, and slowly but surely as they grow older and become more mature, you can delve deeper into the meaning and the intricacies of the statement. However, they have to understand, they have to be familiar, their ears have to be accustomed to hearing the expression of La ilaha illallah, and that it is comprised of two elements, negation and affirmation. Negation, negating any divinity for any creature, and then attesting and confirming it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Secondly, we have to introduce to the children the purpose of life, and the purpose of life is embodied in the expression of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have not created jinn and ins except to worship me. So the children should understand the vast concept of worship, and that it is not restricted to five daily prayers or fasting in Ramadan or performing Hajj. It's actually, the scope is much wider and broader than that. But again, in small bits and in bite sizes, you deliver this information to the children. Thirdly, from aqidah point of view, you shouldn't scare the children too much with the fire and the anger of Allah Azza wa Jal and His punishment, because that will make them associate the concept of Allah with negativity. And there are other extremes, obviously, like who say, no, you shouldn't mention that at all. No, our deen is of that of targhib and tarheeb, of encouragement and fear. And so you want to balance between encouraging them about the rewards of Allah, you tell them about the paradise that Allah prepared for the believers. At the same time, you want to scare them from the things they should be scared of. You don't want to be giving them too much hope with no fear, or too much fear with no hope. There has to be a balance between the two. Fourthly, we should teach our children to love Allah Azza wa Jal more. How do you teach them that? By making them recognize that Allah is the creator, sustainer, provider. He gave us food, He gave us drink, He gave us clothing. All of these are from Allah and by Allah. And the more they understand them and they acknowledge them, the more they will develop the love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will conclude with that. In the next episode, we will continue some more tips on the aqidah aspect before we delve into other issues of ibadah and so forth. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.